friends, I am Sheetal and welcome back to Target Study YouTube channel. Thousands of you have seen and appreciated our video on one of the most sought after course in the field of medical lab technology, that is Diploma in Medical Lab Technology, and some of you have asked for details of a bachelor's degree in the same field. So today, I am here with one such course which is known as Bachelor of Science in Medical Lab Technology, which is also known as B.Sc MLT in common parlance. By the end of the video, you will know answers to all of your obvious questions like what exactly B.Sc MLT course is, what are the required eligibility conditions to join B.Sc MLT course, what are the skills required to do B.Sc MLT course, how to join B.Sc MLT course, what is the syllabus of B.Sc MLT course, what is the fee structure of B.Sc MLT course, which are the various government and private institutes offering B.Sc MLT course, what are the career prospects and job opportunities after completion of B.Sc MLT course, which are the top recruiters of B.Sc MLT degree holders, what are the expected pay packages or salaries after doing B.Sc MLT degree, and much more. So guys, let us start with a very basic question, and that question is, what exactly B.Sc MLT course is? B.Sc MLT, or Bachelor of Science in Medical Laboratory Technology, is a full-time 3-year undergraduate degree program. B.Sc MLT course focuses on various aspects of healthcare. Aspirant perform various diagnostic analysis on body fluids, including hematology, bacteriology, immunology, chemical and microscopy, etc. The important subjects that are taught in the program includes clinical endocrinology and toxicology lab, diagnostic molecular biology lab, diagnostic cytology, etc. The main objective of B.Sc MLT course is to teach various testing methods that are followed while conducted tests without any errors, such as blood test, blood typing, urine analysis and other tests. The course offers a study of diagnosing the disease by utilizing a clinical laboratory. Now, when you are well aware of the B.Sc MLT course, you would definitely like to know about the eligibility conditions required to join B.Sc MLT course. As far as educational qualification is concerned, you must have passed 12th examination or its equivalent from a recognized board in science stream with physics, chemistry and biology as main subject. Some colleges may also demand certain minimum percentage of marks at this level that can be anywhere between 55 to 60%. This eligibility criteria might differ little bit depending upon the institute you are willing to join to do your B.Sc MLT course. Along with fulfilling these eligibility conditions, you must have certain set of skills to be able to complete this 3-year B.Sc MLT course successfully, like a good analytical judgment and ability to work under pressure, have a close attention to details which are essential for medical laboratory technicians, because small differences or changes in test substances or numerical readouts can be crucial to a diagnosis. Normal color vision and smelling sense are highly desirable, besides having ability to handle automated laboratory equipment, computer skills are important. For successful problem solving, you should be able to think and make scientific decisions. You should be able to communicate effectively and function as a part of team and be able to collaborate. You must be well organized and capable of managing tasks. You must be able to perform research, possess practical skills and approach your work scientifically. You should be able to think analytically, numerically and have interpersonal awarenesses. And above all, you should be able to handle your work effectively. If you are really looking to do B.Sc MLT, then knowledge of its admission process is a must. Admission to B.Sc MLT course is usually provided by any of the two ways. And the first way is on the basis of merit, formed considering the marks obtained in the qualifying class. In this method, after successfully applying for admission to the respective colleges, candidates will be asked to appear for the selection processes as defined by each individual college. Prior to the selection process, the medical universities or colleges will release the appropriate merit list containing the name of the candidates along with their ranks, which would be calculated based on the previous academic records. Depending on the rank of the candidate as per the merit list, their preferred choice of college or university and the availability of seats in the preferred choices, the medical college or university will offer admission to the aspirant. However, most of reputed BSc MLT institute provide admission to their BSc MLT course on the basis of rank obtained in the entrance exam conducted at institute, university or state level entrance exam. After attempting the entrance exam, the conducting body will release the appropriate merit list containing the name of candidates along with their scores and ranks. Based on the ranks and scores of the aspirants, as per the entrance test and merit list prepared by the institution, each candidate will be asked to appear for the counseling processes conducted by the authorized body. The medical institution will offer admission to the courses based purely on the ranks and scores obtained by the applicants in the entrance examination, the course and college chosen, and the availability of seats in the preferred choices. Some of the widely taken entrance exams for providing admission to BSc MLT course are Karnataka CET, Kerala Engineering Architecture Medical Entrance Examination, AP EAM CET, and Jamia Hamdard Entrance Test, etc. Now, you would like to know the syllabus of BSc MLT course. This 3-year full-time BSc MLT course has been divided into 6 semesters of 6 months each. BSc MLT course covers the subjects related to clinical endocrinology and toxicology lab, diagnostic molecular biology lab, diagnostic cytology, etc. In BSc MLT semester 1, you will study subjects like Human Anatomy 1, Human Physiology 1, Biochemistry 1, Health Education and Health Communication, PC Software Lab, Human Anatomy 1 Lab, Human Physiology 1 Lab, and Biochemistry 1 Lab. Whereas, BSc MLT Semester 2 consists of subjects like Human Anatomy 2, Human Physiology 2, Biochemistry 2, Biomedical Waste Management, Human Anatomy 2, Practical of Human Physiology 2, Practical of Biochemistry 1, and Communication Lab. BSc MLT Semester 3 usually consists of subjects like Pathology 1, Clinical Hematology 1, Microbiology 1, Immunology and Serology 1, Histopathology and Histotechniques 1, Clinical Hematology 1 Lab, Microbiology, Immunology and Serology 1 Lab, and Histopathology and Histotechniques 1 Lab. In BSc MLT Semester 4, you study subjects like Pathology 2, Clinical Hematology 2, Microbiology 2, Immunology and Serology 2, Histopathology and Histotechniques 2, Clinical Hematology 2 Lab, Microbiology, Immunology and Serology 2 Lab, and Histopathology and Histotechniques 2 Lab. Whereas, BSc MLT Semester 5 consists of subjects like Immunohematology and Blood Banking, Clinical Enzymology and Automation, Parasitology and Virology Diagnostic, Diagnostic Cytology, Principles of Lab Management and Medical Ethics, Clinical Enzymology Lab, Parasitology and Virology Lab, and Diagnostic Cytology Lab. In BSc MLT Semester 6, you study subjects like Clinical Endocrinology and Toxicology, Advanced Diagnostic Techniques, Molecular Biology, Clinical Endocrinology and Toxicology Lab, Advanced Diagnostic Techniques Lab, Diagnostic Molecular Biology Lab, and Internship Project. Here I would like to bring to your kind notice that the syllabus may vary somewhat from institute to institute, but the core subjects of the course will remain same across the institutes. Now you must be curious to know about the fee of BSc MLT course. Like other courses, the fee of BSc MLT course vary depending upon the gender and the reputation of the institute you are going to join. Like, if you got admission in some government institute, then you may have to shell out somewhere between ₹25,000 to ₹30,000 per year. Whereas, private BSc MLT institute may charge as high as ₹1 lakh to 2.5 lakhs per year. Now, let me tell you about some of the top BSc MLT institutes of India. If you are looking for some of the best government microbiology institutes, then you can go for Bangalore Medical College and Research Institute, Bangalore, Karnataka, Government Medical College, Kozhikode, Kerala, Government Medical College and Hospital, Chandigarh, Jamia Hamdard University, New Delhi, and King George Medical University, Lucknow, Uttar Pradesh. And if you want to join some of the best private institutes, then you can go for Chandigarh University, Manipal Academy of Higher Education, Manipal, Karnataka, Sikshao Anusandhan University, Bhubaneswar, Odisha, SRM Institute of Technology, Kanchipuram, Tamil Nadu, and Christian Medical College, Vellore, Tamil Nadu, etc. For complete list of BSc MLT institutes in India, you can visit our website targetstudy.com's institute section and look for the college you want to apply for. Now, here are the career prospects and job opportunities after BSc MLT course. A bachelor's degree in MLT can offer one of the most exciting career opportunities with utmost job satisfaction. After your BSc MLT degree, you can find work both in government as well as private sectors. With BSc MLT degree, you get opportunities to be employed in the following sectors or domains such as pathology labs, research labs, pharmaceuticals, and government and corporate hospitals. The MLT field includes areas such as blood banking, clinical chemistry, hematology, immunology, microbiology, cytotechnology, urine analysis, and blood sampling, etc. So, there are ample of fields that can serve as suitable career option for the graduates. BSc in MLT provides ample job opportunities in the healthcare sector. Every hospital and healthcare sector needs clinical lab technicians to detect problems and diseases causing the patients. Hence, it is creating more job opportunities for the graduates of BSc in MLT. Some of the jobs that can be offered to BSc in MLT graduates can be CT scan technicians, pathology technician, MRI technician, optical laboratory technician, X-ray technicians, dental machine technician, radiology technician, laboratory technician, laboratory manager, research associate, medical record technician, lab assistant, and laboratory testing manager, etc. Besides these options, candidates can go for higher degree in the field like MSc MLT followed by PhD and go in the field of education or research. Opening one's own laboratory can be another option for those with good entrepreneurial skills. Some of the top recruiters that you can think of joining after completing your BSc MLT are Alile Life Science, Alpha Pharma Healthcare India Private Limited, Onyosum Private Limited, Pharma Instinct Private Limited, Siren Technology Private Limited, Mascot International, various government and corporate hospitals and laboratories, etc. Now, the most frequently asked question is, what are the proposed pay packages or salaries after completing BSc MLT course? The BSc MLT degree holder can expect an average starting salary between Rs. 3 to 5 lakhs annually. And if you are joining some government organization, you will get salary as per the prevailing pay scale in the particular state or central government department. So that is all there to know about the BSc MLT program. I hope you enjoy watching this video. If it is so, then please click the like button. Please press the bell icon to receive automatic notification. We'll be back with more videos on such informative topics. Thank you for taking the time to watch.